for the recording, basically, we are in our final module. There is our multiplayer design. You're creating a so for this assignment for the multiplayer map, we're creating a document. Again, I'm looking for a gameplay section. Just how does the level play? Next is looks. Indicate from what, and this is one of those, I want you to go back and look at the levels in Quake and use the style that is in the Quake design methodology. All right, I don't want you going off and trying to like build something new. I want you to use what's in Quake. So go and look at like what like one or two levels that you're going to take inspiration from to build. And pick only one or two levels. So like you do any more than that, you're going in a very different, you're probably pushing the envelope. The start level can't be one of these, because the start level is unique, that it encompasses pieces from different looks. The start level is unique in that it encompasses, like, you go in this section of the level for episode 2, and that has that particular look. And over here is episode 3, has a particular look. Episode 1 has a particular look. So don't use the start map is a bad example for in terms of textures, textures and design. Go into the episodes E1 or E2 or whatever level that you level, you know, go in there and look at those levels instead. You can also, there are a couple deathmatch levels. Those are worthwhile to look at in terms of style and design. Those are a reflection of other levels as well. Your level should fit in with the levels from Quake. So even though it's multiplayer, it should feel in home. Like I'm not asking you to come up with a new. This is why I'm not trying to have you make a new design. I want you to have something that fits in with the current levels with Quake 1. All right, we're not building something out of Quake 2 or Quake 3 or Call of Duty. You're not building the Normandy map or the Hoth map from a Star Wars game. You're not building. What's the Halo map? The Gulch map. What was that? Blood Gulch. Yeah. Like you're not building things with like that has a lot of terrain. You're not building the terrain in it. You're building back down on as multiplayer map. There is one design style that I will let you consider. It's called Space Map, and it was. Quake 3 and Unreal Tournament really pushed the envelope with these particular maps. We'll just go longest yard. Longest yard, Quake 3, because we don't want the movie. And I brought up. Here we go. So in here, basically, you don't have walls. You are floating in outer space, and this is a deathmatch level. One thing that we don't have here, you don't have jump pads and ramps like these. What you don't have, and I think I mentioned before, there's a little platform over here where the railgun in Quake 3 exists. You don't have that capability to make those jumps like that, not easily at all. But this is a deathmatch level in Quake 3. It's a style of deathmatch. This is something you can do in Quake 1. It wouldn't be out of the ordinary. It would be different. It would be out of the ordinary. I might act like the way I might actually have you do it is have you like use the teleport texture as the shell. Basically, you'd have a big shell of a level. So your face would not be a problem in this level. Because you're basically using a big shell. And I'd probably use the teleport material on that because we're in outer, you're in outer space. There's a couple other space space levels. The Unreal Tournament, the one is Facing Worlds. But Facing Worlds, I gotta mention, is this is here we go. Traditional Facing Worlds. So this one, again, they actually have the Earth in the level. But the thing about this particular level, why I'm pointing it out, just so you can see it, this is a capture flag level, just so you know. But sit down and, like, the first thing you really should sit down is sit down and lay out your level. And that's the third thing with your level, is that a level layout. Embedded image into your document includes a level layout element scheme. So you're going to put down, hey, there's supposed to be a health pickup here. There's supposed to be this here. Label them. Have a key. Like, you'll have a, basically an icon on your, and this is something I've dinged people on multiple times. In the bigger level design document. Excuse me, I'm about to sneeze. that was pepper. Excuse me. sit down and think about how your level is put together. One of the problems in one of the Quake deathmatch levels is that they put the rocket launcher and I think a mega health and I think a couple ammo pieces all in this a little corridor room, and you can basically once you get down there in there you're like, come at me, and so that this is one of the things. Think about flow in your levels. All right, that's a bad example of flow. Like, if a player can hole up and just sit there and pound people who are coming after them that way, that's a bad map design. Now, that's, you know, Quake 1, who knew? There are things to play with there. So just keep an eye. A map to keep within... Marathon is a series of games before Bungie made Halo, and they are loosely connected to the Halo universe, but one of the maps is called Thunderdome. And essentially, there's this ring. Basically, it's kind of simple. There is a little pit of lava here. In here, there's the rocket launcher. There is stuff around the edges here. There's an upper ledge up here and a couple of rooms to spawn in at. And it has some goodies in there as well. Pretty simple, straightforward. But one of the things, again, what I'm pointing out is that the rocket launcher is here. At any point, anywhere in the arena, you can turn and look at anyone going for the rocket launcher and start shooting at them. It's a high-risk reward scenario. And that's something I want you to consider, something to consider with your level design, is that, hey, what is the flow through the level, how things should be moving around. Again, this is big chaos because people are roving around. This is the upper layer, the lower level, the center, and the rooms. It's pretty straightforward. It is chaos how people move through the level, so you wouldn't worry too much about that. The only thing you might want to do, you could do, is throw in some cover in some places. I think right here, I think the wall's a little bit higher, so there's cover coming out of the rooms, so it's not like doors open, whoop, pop, which is possible in these games if you're not paying attention, not being careful. Again, we talk about movement. I'll bring up Ice World. Yes. There we go. And this is pretty much a square map with a couple pieces here, and then four blocks in the middle with some bevel edges. What's up? What was that? We don't know. I don't think we have ice physics.
No,
it doesn't have ice physics.
Oh, okay.
No, it's just a map that is just snow covered.
Oh, okay. I thought that was like.
Yeah, no.
Are you
going to
be sliding around like?
No. Oh. And you can see here with this, again, this is a team deathmatch level. So this is one side spawns here, the other side spawns here, and you can see in this version of the map, they have weapons down, which is typical in an ice world, that there are weapons strewn across the back area for people to pick up. And the thing, again, this is a symmetrical on two axes. Yeah, let's take.
Possible.
No. Two Fort is a Quake map. Was originally in the CTF. Okay. So the original, I think Two Fort is. There's a version of Two Fort, in the original CTF for Quake. For Quake.
So I remember the Two Fort just classic one. It went very similar to.
Yeah. No. I mean, like, there's team. So there's. I mean, like, TF2. There's carrots from the TF. There's a version that Valve made, and then there's a version from Quake. Like three wave basically is the pinnacle of is where Team Fortress comes from. But Two Fort is a classic map from Quake era. It's been what we see from there to where we're for Team Fortress 2. Radically different maps, but the DNA is back in Quake. Let's just bring up Two Fort. Let's bring up the TF2 version. I mean the layout. Here we go. So here's the red spawn rooms, the area back here. Again, this is a capture flag map. Which is part of, I think it's might be in the CTF map sections.
It is in the CTF. Yeah.
In yeah, I mean there's I mean it goes back to that to the capture flag, of you know three way mob.
You were talking about like holding down an angle and just shooting down a hallway. Since there is sewer parts in a 2-4 map, how would that?
That's different though because.
It's the swangle. Why do you understand?
Yeah, but that this is let me actually just come in. Let me actually jump into Quake and show you the level. Expel someone from that room once they've set up. Once they've got, like, and particularly if they've gone on, they've got an armor or they've got, like, any of the power-ups to get into that room. So it's hard to expel someone from that room once they've set up in set up shop, basically.
What if it's, like, a game of, like, I'm not sure if you've ever played, but Duck Hunt. It's a game of from Halo or Team Fortress 2 where one guy is in the sky base with a rocket launcher or a sniper rifle. Team has to go through certain levels. The and what they could support.
Yeah, but you're talking about a team-based thing. Yeah, I mean, like, basically, if you're gonna, let's back up one more, Like, if you're gonna put the rocket launch is one of the more powerful weapons in Quake. You need to use that. That is a something for someone to go after in a high risk way. or your level is basically it's a rocket arena. Rockets, you know, it doesn't matter because there's rockets all over the place. You know, you can either make it a high risk reward scenario or make it as common as possible for your level. And that's, there is rocket arenas essentially where basically people are running around. There's actually a game mode mods where people have just basically gone around. Basically, the only weapon you have is the rocket. Excuse me. So, let me just get back. The idea, again, I'm talking about design theory right here. Again, the first thing that you need to have is a plan. All right? And if you've got multiple levels, that's perfectly, like, the level I did was the M4. That I probably would have done, I would have laid out in multiple levels. Because they would be the central chamber that, you know, going up and down, I'd have a diagram for that. I'd probably have a diagram on the side, like, here's level 1, level 2, level 3, looking on the side. But then I would have each of those sub-levels sections as their own sub-piece of the map. Like, this is how this section would look and how it would, you know, be built. And this is how this section would be built. I mean, it is basically 3-4-ish levels in there. There's, like, 4 distinct different levels. And so I would like, lay this is the bottom floor. Here's the middle floor. Here's the top floor. Here's that upper subsection. And so that, you know, it makes sense in terms of how I'm going to build it, how it all works together. Again, that I would then have, again, that vertical diagram just to illustrate, you know, how high they're supposed to go, how big that column is. Also, you know, you basically, again, particularly with that level, those teleporters are really important. And they're not two-way teleporters. Like, you go one way and come back the other, you're going to come out another way. So it's not necessarily they can be one-way teleporters. And you can build those one way. You know, I've shown you how to build them two-way, but you don't have to. They can be one way in this particular case. I go in the teleporter this way, I come back, and I come out of the teleporter, get back the other way. You know. You've got that freedom to do. And I would probably just run around the deathmatch levels in Quake just to give it a feel, because that's kind of what your the size and scope, and that's what you're gonna have. You'll be able to build. Again, you've got one basically a month, five weeks total. I mean, ideally, basically at the end of this month, you know, so 4 classes again, last class of this month. You should be basically, you know, fiddling just with lights and detail pieces, decorating, giving your level style and, you know, character. Can I show something I pointed out in one of your levels? Okay. You did it in all of them. That's the interesting thing. So here we go. So here we go. Here's something that Emily did in she did all of her levels, but this is one of the cases where she did. She basically had an area here pointing out to the sky, and then she just threw in these rushes in here to break it up. It almost looks like a Flappy Bird level. Excuse me for the comparison. But, you know, basically, I mean, and that gave this window opening uniquely in her style. Go back, take a look at things. Let's take, again, I do have the files. Open document. I mean, you do have the sources for all the maps. So let's take a look at, let's take a look at DM6. First thing I need to do is add the quick 1-1-1. Oh, I should just do that one more time. When I added it this time, add it to relative to the application executable. If you do it this particular way, because if you do absolute, I've got basically it's looking to your specific file on the drive. Use it relative to the executable. Either that or relative to the game directory. Those are one of the two you'd want to use here. This is will make it easier to bring your map across, so it's not looking. So you can see up here in this area. You know, there's a certain set of textures they're using. They've got these pieces right here. You know, there's a lot of angle. This, you know, part of this map is there's, you know, the ceilings are angled. You know, there's a race between two different rooms, and it's angled here. That these should probably be down. They should be like that in order to not form ZBrush. I would have probably clipped these off as well. So you can see here is they've got some sky here, and they've got, you know, they've built, you know, the ceiling here with these pieces right here. So this room right here, again, we were up here before. This is the bottom half of this room now. Teleporters through here. Up here is, and you've got to teleport up through here. So teleporters are a theme in a lot of these levels, is that there are some teleporters. Where is... Just looking for spawn points. So the other thing I wanted to point out, now I'm here, is that you don't have an info player start, you have an info player deathmatch. These are the starting. This is where a player could spawn when they start into the level. You need at least 8. What happens if you don't have enough of those? Players will spawn on top of each other, and they will spawn on top of each other. And when you spawn on top of another entity, you telefrag it. So if I had only like one of these info player deathmatch, and I put 8 of them, we'd be in this loop of telefragging each other. Until someone manages to get out for some reason. And then there's 7 now in that cycle. Hooray. So please, please, make sure that you have... the other thing that we need to do to test it in... as a deathmatch level is you need to put your... use a command line arm called listen. So basically it makes it a listen server. So basically, there is in the world of client. There's three types of applications, you know, in terms of the client server world. There is the client itself. Basically, I've connected to a server, and the server can be in listen mode. Basically, I've got a client connected to my server, so someone's playing on the server itself. So I'm a server and the client at the same time. And then there's dedicated, which basically means I am just basically a server, and I don't have a client connected to me, so other people are connected to it. So in our case, we're going to use listen 8, allow up to 8 players. And this will then take the map that you're working on. When you compile and you run the map, it will then run it in a deathmatch server as opposed to a single player. Now you could do there is co-op. That's basically you're running basically a multiplayer machine, a single player map in on a server essentially. Just putting that out. But basically, again, we're building a deathmatch level. Quake is weird is that you can go through. So if you're on a server, you can do both multiplayer and single player maps at the same time. And there are I know start map is a common deathmatch level for some reason. I don't know why. It's just been there. But people can jump, have been able to jump. Like, you can, if depending on the setup of how the server set up, I know start map may block off the teleporters, but there are cases where those teleporters are open, and you jump through one, and everyone goes to the next map. So, co-op and deathmatch are this weird, it's not clean. So you can go through a single player. You can do the single player. You can make a multiplayer, have everyone connect, and then go from start to, it can get weird like that.
I can only imagine.
Yeah, it's part of the history of Quake. There is this, the fact that they actually do have deathmatch levels is, the fact wasn't always the case. I mean, like, you go back to Doom, and there weren't really deathmatch levels with Doom, so this was an evolution with Quake. So, getting back to the document one more time. There we go. So, map requirements. I've told you what you need for here. This is what I'm expecting in terms of the map itself. Design a map for a map arena for Quake Deathmatch. We'll be playing the maps, and then you need to at least 2-3 weapons, not counting the axe or the shotgun. Ammo for all the weapons used. Include shells in your map as the player starts with a shotgun. Nate, your hand was up. Is there a question? Okay. At least the yellow armor. I would say at least one of the armors. You don't have to... At least one of the armors. You should. So again, I'm trying to there are pickups. There is the included mega health. Again, go to put down a health pack. Go into the spawn flags. You can make it into a mega health. Definitely a quad damage. There is the quad. There is the pentagram, and there's also the ring of shadows of the two other primary. I don't know if there's any. Those are the three primary power ups, but at least the quad damage. Right. And think about how do you get to your quad damage? Where is it? It's a small level. It's okay to have smaller rooms and halls wrapping around the main room. Like again, that level I pointed out is basically three floors with a cord or a cylinder. A shaft going up and down between them. But we're not, and that's probably as big as you'd probably want to go with that map. You don't want to. We're not asking. This is not. Again, we're going back to classic deathmatch. This is not open world environment. This is not. We're not building two forts. We're not building. We're not invading. We're not doing like assault, which is basically one team is defending off another team from getting through the map. We don't have vehicles. We don't have terrain. In fact, this game wasn't designed for those big areas. So keep it small, keep it tight, and you know, look, think about how you get the player to flow around the room. I put the rocket here. I put health here. I put the rockets for the rocket launcher over here, and I put something else over here. It's a think about how the player should be moving through the level. You know, if you're gonna highlight the rocket launcher again or the thunderbolt as the prize weapon to have in the map, then it needs to be in an area where like, oh, someone's going for that. Let's go. We should stop him. Conversely, the other way to go with it is to make a map where that is common as heck. Load it with rocket launchers and rockets. Heck, do a level with the Thunderbolt with cells, but make sure you've got a lot of water in that level, because that's hilarious. They fall in these sorts of stuff like that. I'd have another weapon as a backup in that, as opposed to the Thunderbolt. When you spawn in the listen server, monsters won't show up. Just so you know. So don't think about you're going to have like these. Your PvE elements is basically the level is doing stuff to people. There's not monsters in the level. Go light on scripting because you're not doing challenge. You know, if you've got a challenge, then that's to unlock something. But that's something like you're not doing. You're shooting like it's something that if you have in your level, it's something that is repeatable. It's not a one and done scenario. Or if it's one and done, it opens up permanently. Any questions for me about what is expected? Again, I'm looking for a design document. Doesn't have to be, this is what you're trying to target. Doesn't have to be exact. You could get it, like literally, you could get into Trench Room and be like, this was a bet, this is not working. And rebuild it and reform it as you need to. That's perfectly fine. What I'm looking for right now is what is the ideas are you trying to pull together right now as you build this level? Any questions?
Yep. So we can use the rocket launchers in our
It's perfectly fine. But you know, give this is where give yourself cover and space. If you're gonna figure the Roger one, you need a lot of cover. You know, it needs to be I can shoot here, I can shoot there. It's an A or B. You know, I know you're behind that cover. Are you gonna go A? You're gonna go B? It's a crazy. If you've ever seen Red October, there's something called Crazy Ivan, and basically there's one sub behind the other, and it's basically a guess whether you are following you're gonna follow them correctly. It's an A or B choice. I know you're behind cover. You're about to move. Are you going to go A or are you going to go B? And that becomes right there. There's a gameplay piece right there, a sub game within the game that you can use with cover and the correct weapons. Any other questions? Get this document done today. And then this is again. Go use Scroll. Go use use the tools. There are we did Dungeon Scroll. We just bring up Dungeon Scroll. Free old school. And again, this is like this right here would be way too much already for your map. Just saying, like if you just took this image right here and built that, that would be way too much in terms of your map area. Particularly with all the to make this look good. And this is, again, the other issue is that, you know, you've got, like, these tight corridors, which you don't particularly want. This is folded over, but this is half of a map for Frag. Here's a room right here. Here's a room right here. There's doors here. They've got pits of slime you can try and jump over. A little room in here. These actually, I actually did map one of these out in Unreal Tournament, and they actually played not too bad. So, Frag is a board game that is supposed to simulate a first-person shooter. It's from Steve Dashen Games. I actually have a My copy is in my car, actually. So I will probably go get those in a little later. I'm going to stop the recording right here. And let you get the document done first.